Welcome back to HBO Girls Rewatch.
I'm Amelia.
And I'm Evan.
And can you tell I didn't sleep here last night?
Uh-oh. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. We did move Amelia to her new apartment in Williamsburg yesterday.
It was pouring rain. I don't know if any of you have ever tried to rent a U-Haul virtually, but it wasn't so virtual. What happened?
Wait, what happened?
I talked to a lot of agents, and I tried really, really hard not to become my mother.
Agents on an industry?
I was literally standing on the street in the rain going over and over and over. Like, I am calm.
I will say every time you move and have to interact with men, it's like, it's never positive. You're always leaving a one-star review somewhere.
This is what I'm saying. It's like, thank God all the chat agents were girls. Because if there had been a man on the line, I would have
freaked.
I would have gone there.
I kind of wish I captured the last time you talked to Rabbit Movers.
Oh my God, let's dox them on the pod. Don't use their program. But whatever. It's so crazy to have to car to here.
It's kind of fun to take for you to drive a U-Haul around New York City, and then for you to kind of learn how to parallel park in a process. And you actually did a really good job, except you parked half in a bike lane, but like, still, that was pretty good. I could never do that.
As somebody who's always driving through Grand Street on a bike, let me tell you, nobody respects the bike lane. If anything, I left so much room compared to what I've been through. I actually think I was being really thoughtful.
Some people didn't get their door dashes on time, but overall, it was kind of a fun experience.
I'm just so mad at the black car that pulled in that giant spot and sat there for no reason. I was like, can you not see little old me in a U-Haul?
The biggest car imaginable.
It's also like me in a U-Haul with my boys, like with my muscle, like in the side.
Honestly, it was so easy moving in yesterday. All you have is a desk and a dresser.
Can you imagine I unpacked everything in 2 podcast episodes?
Yes, you did so fast.
How are you? You just ate a bunch of sausage. Well, you were gone on Sunday, but our other roommate threw a lovely barbecue for their family.
No, not our other roommate. My other roommate.
Okay. And just like that.
The lines are gone now.
Just like that.
I did go to a diner with 7 friends last night until 1 a.m.
A diner?
Yeah, in Park Slope.
Oh my God, I know which diner.
You do?
Yeah, I've been to that diner.
Isn't it so random and fun? And it's actually really good, and you're not expecting that.
I went there with a lot of people who now are SNL writers.
Really?
And the way their past and my past are so different is beautiful.
You mean
and
one
awesome.
That's an SNL writer?
Just one, yeah.
But that's a lot of people in the group for just one.
Well, and one of them works for the New York Times, which I just is like, it's basically like working in
SNL. Isn't she a graphic designer?
It's boy.
Oh, him.
Yeah.
I don't know who he is.
Yeah.
But it's honestly so magical for 7 people to be laughing at the top of your lungs and everyone order something for the table.
That's amazing.
It was magic. Yeah.
It's heaven on earth.
You have to be ordering for the table.
We're almost to the end of Girls.
I know, we're so close.
It really is feeling like all these episodes
left after this.
It really is feeling like these episodes are wrapping up. Like all the previous seasons.
Like they know the show's ending.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Like
how
you
they
can
did that.
Tell every plot point is like referencing old plot points, whereas I feel like it used to be more generative. It's now more reflective.
Oh, that's a really, those are some fun words and really accurate.
Tiv.
Yeah, it is like all these characters are going to experience more growth in the next 4 episodes than they did maybe the 5 seasons before this.
And ain't that always the way?
Ain't that always the way, literally.
Anyways, we're so excited for our guest. She's all the way from LA, which is chic as fuck.
She went to Tulane, where I went as well. So I'm like,
so
I can't wait to roll wave with her.
That.
Yeah, it's going to be so exciting.
Oh my God, let's cross this off to her now. Joining us on the couch right now, it's Sally Darr.
Oh my God.
Oh my God.
Extraordinaire.
Our first LA guest. We have full body chills.
That is like actually really insane that I'm your first LA guest.
I'm like, to us, you represent the entire state of California.
Wait,
really,
you're
really scary.
You're not the first LA guest. You're the first guest to never leave LA. Every other guest has kind of been in New York.
We have people
kind of,
who were born and raised LA, which is...
Okay.
We're kind of live there now and then we're in New York for a week.
Yeah, okay. So I'm the first LA resident that knows basically nothing about New York.
Exactly.
Well, can we announce to everybody that this is your first time in Brooklyn, New York?
It's true.
Oh my God. Oh my God, you guys.
But like, what a good reason to come to Brooklyn for the first time.
Right.
Like
girls.
The only reason I would want to be in
Brooklyn.
We're
welcoming you. We're like, this is what it looks like.
Yeah.
We'll talk about what's all about.
I wish we could open this house out to tourists. They could just like look at this wall or something, charge them a fee.
That'll be our next
the
chapter.
Girls experience.
People are like, what are you doing after Girls? It's like giving tours.
We're getting a white shuttle. We're going around Brooklyn.
Giving tours. When were you watching Girls for the first time?
I was in high school.
Oh my God, early?
Because it came out in like 2012.
Yeah.
So I remember I went to boarding school and I came home for like Thanksgiving
or
Christmas.
Where did you go to boarding school?
In Connecticut.
Oh, my God. You went from Tennessee to Connecticut?
Yeah.
Where were you going in Connecticut? Have you felt comfortable saying?
Yeah. It was in a town called Wallingford. Ooh. Like a do-nothing town.
No, but I'm obsessed with people who go to boarding school. They always have scary stories.
Yeah. It wasn't all that scary. I really liked it. I like begged my parents to let me go.
Was it all girl?
No, it was co-ed.
Sick.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, really hot. Did not talk to a single boy there. But no, I came home for a break, like Thanksgiving or Christmas. And my older sister was a senior in high school, like still in my hometown. And my mom and my sister, they were like, you need to watch this show. Like I think it like maybe one or two episodes. It was like the first few episodes were out and they're like, you need to watch this. And I remember watching it and having like a spiritual experience.
But your mom in Tennessee was like, you have to watch Girls.
Yeah.
When you were 15 years old. That's awesome.
Yeah. And so then I just like watched it. What?
Are you from Nashville or Knoxville?
Oh, I'm from Chattanooga.
You're from Chattanooga?
Yeah. I know about Chattanooga.
City. Really? What do you know about it?
All the girls in my high school who were volleyball girls went to play volleyball in Chattanooga.
Wait, what?
Oh, like for a tournament or something?
No, like they're like just got signed like to go to Chattanooga to play.
Oh, like UTC Chattanooga. Like UT Chattanooga. Okay.
And I'm like, yes, Brianna. You go, girl.
Okay. I didn't know they were doing like big volleyball school.
Maybe it was just her and her friend group. They were all really excited though.
Oh, that's great. Yeah. I hope they liked it.
So your mom's cool. That's awesome.
Yeah, pretty cool. But yeah, I just had a spiritual experience. So then I just like, I watched it. I kept up to date. I think there was like maybe like one season that I was like, oh, I didn't realize it was out yet. Like I pretty much watched it in real time. Like since my mom told me about it. Yeah.
Wait, amazing. Love. Mm-hmm. I don't. Usually people aren't finding a show from their mom. They're finding it from their dorm mates.
Right.
Did you have cable in the dorms or are you desperate to come home to watch?
Yeah, we didn't have cable. I mean, we just had laptops. I mean, some dorms, I guess, had like TVs in the common room, but like not
really.
Wait,
is this pre-streaming?
I think
they had to have HBO Go.
Yeah, there was definitely that. But I'm trying to think like where Netflix was at the time.
I feel like Orange is the New Black was coming out.
Yeah.
Right? Like Netflix was just starting to do original content.
Right.
Wait, what was Netflix like when it first started streaming? Was it just like Orange is the New Black and that's like the only thing you could play?
Or
was there other stuff on there too?
It was like a lot of like Grey's Anatomy. It was a lot of like procedurals or like One Tree Hill. That's when I saw One Tree Hill. For me, it's like all I remember is One Tree Hill. It's 9 seasons of that. Let's dive into the episode. So we're at season 6, episode 6. Is that true?
Yeah, it is.
Full disclosure, we are going to summarize the episode in 1 minute. Do you think you can help us?
Yeah, maybe. I feel like I'm going to mess up the order, but I'm going to try to help.
No worries.
6-6 is like, I hope there's one. I'm actually really into angel numbers right now.
Oh, great. And I love that.
I was seeing 666 for so many months.
Oh, God.
And actually, the last week I started seeing 777, so I know something good's in my horizon.
Yeah. Adam says the movie in this episode is 47 minutes and 47's my lucky number. I was like, okay, this week's gonna be awesome. Okay.
Is 47, does that mean short or feature? Does it have to be an hour to be a feature?
Here's the thing, 47 minutes is so funny because it's like he wants to apply for festivals and it's like that's a length that no festival will accept.
No, they want 10.
They want under 14 minutes or above 100 or something.
I think I'll
right?
know this information so we can apply it to Adam.
I made up these numbers, by the way, but they feel true to me.
What does he say about it too? He's like, it won't like take up your day, like it won't take any of your time. It's just 47
it's
minutes.
Just
so like that's a decent chunk of time.
I'm like, that's really long.
No, it's only one Ugly Betty episode.
It's more than that episode of Girls.
True.
Yeah.
But we both remarked that this is like one of the longest feeling episodes of all time of Girls.
I literally checked it watching last night. Like, is this longer than all the other ones? It wasn't.
No, it's not 8 minutes more.
It's just because Rita Wilson.
I just think there's a lot of jump cuts and jump cuts really add time.
Yeah. Okay. Let's synopsize this. Ready, set, go.
Oh, and that's a really great question.
I know where it starts.
You start.
Because I'm going to mess up the middle. It starts with Marnie and Hannah in Hannah's apartment saying like, Marnie says like, oh, I have big news, but I don't want to like, mine's bigger than yours. Ray dumped me. And then Hannah's like, oh, I'm pregnant. And she's like, you're kidding. And she's like, no.
And then literally. Marnie really quickly in under a minute gets really on board and is like, yeah, you're ready, girl boss.
Right. And then Hannah's like, I don't want to do it now.
And and then Hannah goes and hides in the bathroom. Kind of classic.
Yeah.
Joke.
And then Marnie kind of jumps cut too with Desi. And Desi's like, you're actually the reason I was addicted to anything. Music is a reason I'm dying right now. Everything is your fault again. And he always is saying this his whole season. And he's like, he breaks the banjo. He's complaining about money. Marnie's like, we have to go to New Jersey to support my mom's best friend as she turned 60 years old, maybe.
She looks really good for 60.
And then she looks so good for 60.
And then what?
Hannah and Elijah are apologizing because the prior episode of this, he's like, you're not gonna be a good mother, you're gonna be an awful mother. Mm-hmm. And then he's like, actually, I didn't mean all those words. I was just really high or like in a weird mood, and I thought we were gonna be bad together for a little bit longer, but it's actually great you have your shit together. And he's like, actually, it's gonna be our baby and we're gonna raise it together.
And Elijah is a fucking girl boss at his retail job, practicing lines with the coworker who is a Hamilton alum. Let's go. And he's like, wait, I should totally be a star and actor. So he's working on that. I think it's kind of foreshadowing the episode to come where he auditions for that one
right.
thing.
And then Hannah is getting a phone call from who? It's Adam. And he's like, please walk to the store. And she's like, no, I don't really want it. I don't have the time for it. And then she's leaving her apartment on India Street. And who does she run into? Adam, because he's also living in the same apartment on Indy Street, basically, as he visits his nephew. And they're walking down the street, and he's like, please, please watch me. And she's like, actually, I can't. I'm pregnant. And then she runs on off.
She literally runs away from him. Mm-hmm. And then Jessa knock, knock, knocks on Hannah's door and is like, why didn't you tell me you were pregnant? Why'd you tell Adam first? Please be my friend. And Hannah's like, we were never friends. I hate you. Bye. And Jessa's like, come on, you can't pretend it didn't happen. Don't erase me. And Hannah's like, I don't want to deal with you. Get out of my face. And that ends. And then Hannah goes to dinner with her dad and her dad's new boo. And she's like,
should I? Dinner's a strong word because it's hors d'oeuvres. We never see dinner served. We only see courgette.
It's just, yeah. And then she's like, I shouldn't tell Paul Louis, right? He's a puka shell guy and his only days off are Tuesdays and Thursdays.
So funny.
And so then Hannah ends the episode by trying to call for 1 second to Paul Louis, and then it's not working. She's like, never mind. It's
and
not
then
meant
she
to be.
Watches the short itself. Then Marnie is actually at the 50-year-old's mm-hmm. birthday party waiting for Desi to show up, and he's an hour late, but they're freaking out over the owner's biceps. So it's okay because the moms were a little bit distracted. Right before Marnie gets on stage, Desi is nowhere to be found and is kind of having a withdrawal from drugs. So guess who goes up there with Marnie? It's Rita Wilson. And she is not singing. She's scatting, LOL. And Marnie is just like in the world's worst place ever. And that's what you missed on Girls.
There it is.
There it
that was
is.
Great.
There
yeah,
is so
I think
many
we
parts
hit
this episode.
I think we pretty,
it's too
much
many. I was just going to just like one stream of conscious. It's so much. Watching like American Dick to this.
American
Bitch. It's just like that's so much easier to understand.
I know, but this episode was fun because it's. Are you an Elijah head?
Yeah, I love Elijah.
Yeah, it's like some episodes we get so much, and then he'll disappear for 5 episodes. When Elijah kept coming on screen, I was like, "Honey, I love it here."
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, and he's like, also, I have a promising career in acting because they want me to have it.
Yeah.
Who was the character he was referring to?
What?
She was Celeste was her name, or. It was like, yeah. Chariot. Oh, Chariot is like, you have to do this play. And he has Broadway talent and caliber. Sorry, it is a confusing episode.
Before we dive more into the episode, we have a really important question to ask you.
Okay.
Girl, what girl are you?
I'm so scared about this question.
You're like, I haven't slept in days.
No, I actually, my sleep schedule is so messed up because of my Europe
Amsterdam.
Travel. Yeah, no, literally.
Oh, yeah, literally.
But, okay, I think like, are we doing like this week or overall? Because you guys do it by week,
we do
right?
it by week.
But you do
okay.
overall.
But you can also be like in this episode.
Okay.
Give it all to us.
I feel like I need to do like sun, moon, rising kind of vibe.
Please.
That's what we want.
Okay, okay. I think like overall, like in the, my grand scheme of my life, I think I'm a Hannah.
Yeah.
I think in the past year, I've been more of a Marnie, but oh. I think like this week, I'm like so season 6 Shoshana.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, if you can like wrap your head around all of that.
My mind is expanding
yeah.
in real time exponentially.
And I can explain any of those
so
answers.
So what is it that Hannah is really your son?
I think like she needs it to be all about her. You know, I'm a Leo at one point when I first watched the show and she was like, oh, I'm a voice of like, my generation or like a generation, like when I watched that for the first time, I was like, totally, like, so me, like I'm meant to like write the story of my life and have everyone listen to
you
it
at boarding school.
Wait, when I you're watched
like,
it at
yeah
boarding
you're
school?
Watching an episode and you're
no.
kind of going back to boarding school and you're like, I'm gonna write the
no,
next
literally,
American
like,
novel.
Yeah, I think I have that like kind of ego that like Hannah has like when I was younger and stuff. But I think in the past year I've been more of a Marnie because like I don't know, like,
because you started vlogging.
Yeah, totally. No, but I think about like specific lines that they've all said, but there's a line, I think it's in the first episode too, where Marnie says something to Jessa when they're in the bathroom and she's like, you think I'm uptight, so then no, you're so lax, so then I have to be the uptight one, and then you say that I'm uptight, and so then I become uptight. Mm-hmm. Like I think that's been me in the past year. It's like I feel like I I don't want to be the uptight one, but then I like end up being
people
uptight
are
because
making you,
people
yeah.
are making me be uptight. So I feel like I felt like Marnie for the past year in that sense. But like this month, I'm feeling, or this week, I'm feeling like Shoshana, because I think you said it in a recent episode about Jamba Jeans, how like she was realizing like all these different paths her life could have taken, or she could have had these friends and this career. And like, obviously Jamba Jeans is stupid, so it's like that would have been a stupid path. But I watched Everything Everywhere All at Once, which is like in the same vein of like yeah. all of the yeah. different lives that you're, so I've just been thinking about that of like, oh my God, like what if I lived in New York instead of LA? Like what if I had friends that were different from these friends? Or what if I don't know. And then
yeah,
spoiler alert, Shoshana ends up being engaged to a man that we like basically know nothing about, and it's like she decided to take this other path. So I think I'm right now where I am, I'm like, what if I just picked up everything and moved? Or what if I,
oh my God,
yeah. So I've been feeling like Shoshana
Wait,
these days.
I'm like, okay, you're moving to New York, I can feel it, you're over LA.
Totally. But yeah,
that's all sounding really true.
I do mm-hmm. think it's crazy for you to be like, I become uptight because you were in a top sorority at Tulane and then you
oh,
did
God,
6 months on the
that.
Caribbean boat.
Do not say that.
Cut the camera. No, that's awesome that you only had to become Marnie in the last year. As somebody who was mm-hmm. born in Marnie
oh, okay.
and is stuck in Marnie forever, mm-hmm. it's so nice to have people join the crew, but they're new.
Yeah. Like, right. I think when I first was watching Girls, I was like, oh my God, I'm never a Marnie. Like, never, never. But like, yeah, I feel like I'm a Marnie.
Yeah.
These days.
It happens.
More so than Hannah. Yeah, I like don't feel like my story is that important when, like Hannah's anymore.
When you were like 15 and watching it, were you like, Hannah's cool? Or were you like, I don't want to be her? Or were you always like, she sounds awesome?
I think it's kind of like Hannah to me is almost kind of like the Gryffindor, where it's like everyone like default is like, I'm so Hannah, because she's like kind of the main character, yeah. you know? But also like, they all suck in their own way.
Yeah.
Wait, so like there are elements of Hannah that I didn't want to be, but like, I think the fact that she was like, when I was younger, I wanted to be a writer and like, yeah, yeah, like, I don't know. I think
we yeah. have yet to do this, but you bring up an amazing point where it's like, which Harry Potter house is each girl?
Oh my
Huge
God.
Huge point. And if I was to go based off the cuff, I think you're right. Hannah's Gryffindor. Mm-hmm. Jessa's clearly Slytherin.
Yes, I was about to say
Marnie's
that.
Marnie's Ravenclaw. And then we kind of leash Shoshana with Hufflepuff.
Mm-hmm. I was literally thinking the same
yeah,
thing.
And of course, it's an easy one.
Shosha's Hufflepuff. I don't know anything about Harry Potter, but
Elijah might be like a Slytherin.
I think he's like one of those elves that works in a bank.
Mm.
Don't you think if Elijah was in the Harry Potter universe, he'd be bleach blonde?
Oh.
Okay, it's
every gay guy
question.
Has to do that one time.
Based on nothing I know, based on knowing nothing, I'm like, he'd be that blonde mean guy that is on a broom.
No, because that guy has actually really low self-esteem.
Oh, and Elijah's really confident.
He's pretty good, yeah.
Girl, what girl are you this week?
Okay, I'm definitely Rita Wilson's friend that's having
oh
a birthday party.
Oh my God.
I really resonated with her.
In what way?
I'm like, I'm drunk, I'm vaping, I'm not paying attention to what's really going on. If someone's going to scout at my birthday party, actually, mm-hmm. I'm going to laugh and have a good time. And maybe I did do a year with the Fugees on tour. Is yeah. that so wrong?
Yeah. Did you fuck the club owner guy or whatever?
I would love to fuck the club owner yeah. guy. If he was open to an opportunity, I would love to be part of it as well.
To get a Friday night slot in New Jersey. Yeah.
yeah. Mm-hmm. To get, love you. To get the best club in town, I would do anything. And I would yeah. love to have a happy birthday sign at the back of me like that. And I like everyone in the audience because they all
what
are like.
What was her name? Babely?
I hope it's Babely.
I can't remember.
Impossible to know, like, would love for it to be Babely.
They kept
though.
Saying it, and I was like, this isn't a real word.
They're, Hannah, Lena Dunham is one of the best name writers of our time.
I
My
know.
Mom's a professional namer for products, but I'm like, she should be a professional namer for babies. Mm. She's so good at it, and she keeps the world interesting and fun. Oh. No, I could go on and on about that. The 50-year-old's birthday party. It's like, at any age, you can still have a sweet 16, and I believe that in my heart of hearts.
Well, her ability to be like, Marnie, my life has been fun, nothing but fun. I just slay every day here in New Jersey. And Marnie's like, mouth agape, like, there's no way.
You know, I don't think I could slay that hard in New Jersey ever, though. It's not a space for queer people. Except people, you'll be surprised by how many queer people in Brooklyn will defend Jersey City at you. You're like, I never asked you to do this. Why are you bringing it up around me? And then they're actually going on 20 minutes to where like, Jersey is actually a good city. It's like, I don't care or need to invest any energy into this. Okay, girl, what girl are you?
Damn, sorry about that.
I really needed to get that out clearly. Oh my God, wipe your tears. Girl, what girl am I? Well, not to be earnest, but
don't
I'm,
do it, please.
I'm
save
so,
it for another episode.
I'm so Hannah when Jess is like, you can't just erase the past. If there's one thing I'm going to do, it's erase the past.
Yeah, and that's valid.
Yeah, any time, because I keep moving
Can I
majors.
Say one thing?
What?
You're so good at not erasing the past, by the way.
What do you mean?
You're a historian for anything that's ever happened to you.
I mean, know.
We all are, but in a way, you're so... I'm like, I know. I'm a historian for you because I've kind of gotten the badge. You kind
I'm
of
not erasing
so
my past, but I'm erasing the friendships I've had in the past.
Oh. Yeah, because Amelia, we did this math the other day. She thought she moved every 1.5 years because she did 13 moves in 8 years, but she did reverse math by accident. So she she's moving every 8 months.
Gotcha.
Which is one of the craziest numbers, but I love.
But I always am like friends with people and then I stop being friends because I move and then I pretend that I never knew them. So
that's a big part of your early 20s. Okay. Though. It's like when you were doing 6 months in a Caribbean boat, I'm sure you had friends that are now erased.
I honestly like didn't even have friends. So like there was no erasing to do.
It sounds like you went through. I'm like, I need a movie about what you went through.
Yeah. And I could write it. Yeah maybe.
We
yeah.
do have a pilot idea and is that it?
Oh, that was actually, yeah. What I, when I went to film school after I worked on the boat. Yeah. And that was like what my pilot was about. Was
oh my God.
Working on the boat. Yeah.
It's actually good. So fun. Wait, everyone say your pilot idea.
What you go first?
My pilot idea is I couldn't read until I was 13, so I love to do a pilot where I'm like a dyslexic 12-year-old, but I want to paint a 12-year-old and not in a pen 15 way. If
gotcha.
We can make that happen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My pilot is Virgin gets hired as producer for Porn Stars podcast and she has to pretend she knows everything.
I think it's so
but
good.
She doesn't, and it's based on my real life.
Oh, I love that. When I can't believe you went through that. Literally. That's awesome.
You know, when I lived in LA, I had to like produce this porn stars podcast and I just like didn't know what
Which
to
porn
do.
Star can you share?
Lana Rhodes.
Okay, I feel like that may
Doesn't
sound,
it sound
familiar.
Like a vocal warm-up?
She's like number
podcast.
One on Pornhub.
Okay, great.
And then
Maybe
she became a
up.
Mom. And
she's doing vlogs now.
She's like doing mommy vlog stuff. And then she was like, I'm going to be a mommy influencer. And then suddenly she deleted everything. And now
all
she's back to just being
everything.
Just like all the mom stuff. Okay, and now she pretends she's not a mom. I think she wants to protect her kid.
Yeah. Well, I know I was talking about what's his Adam 20. There's some guy, some porn star named Adam 20 something. And then his wife, they have a kid. They're both porn stars. I'm forgetting the other girl's name. But they have a kid and they like don't show her at all because it's like, I mean, I literally are going to be like their kid's going to be sexualized no matter what they do. So it's like you cannot show anything, I feel like.
That's
like which is probably why
kids.
She did that.
Literally.
Yeah.
The Kardashian kids are always being sexualized. I'm like, why am I seeing fan cans and
Molson
like, Kardashian?
It's so problematic.
Any celebrity's kid like is going to be like put in.
I know.
But I'm imagining a porn star and then have it's like that would just be like next level of like people.
It's just really dangerous. I get Kristen Bell's whole thing.
Yeah.
And
wait,
on that amazing note, well, she puts emojis over her kids' faces.
Oh, she does.
Right. Yeah. And she's like really outspoken about it.
Oh, that's so fun.
On her husband's podcast.
On her husband's podcast.
I like when I follow like one girl, like whenever she shows her, it's like always like the back of their head or something. So it's like cute photos, but it's like you never like see their face. I'm like, that's like a classy way to do it.
I love when it's like a family like in front of like the magic castle at Disney World and the faces are just blurred of the kids.
Right. I just wouldn't do the emoji and the blurring. It's like, I'm just like not posting it. I'll just do the, you know, like I'm not trying to.
I personally blurred a magic castle. I don't want people to know I went to Disney World as an adult.
True. Yeah. It's a good point.
There is so much to dive into this episode. Which girl should we start with?
I mean, we don't even touch Shoshana, thank God. I think we had a fourth
girl. Were you
girl
devastated that Shosh wasn't
kind
in
of. I mean, my answer was literally Shoshana. She wasn't even in this episode. I guess I was just thinking about like the whole season where they all are currently, even if she wasn't in it.
And you know what? She just went to Japan, which is just like you just going to Amsterdam.
100%.
That's a parallel.
No, I actually think it's you doing 6 months on a cruise ship or doing it in the Caribbean.
Yeah, that was about 6 years ago.
Did AD Bryant hire you? Yeah.
Yeah, basically. Yeah. Pretty much.
Oh, I have no response to that.
I guess let's start with Hannah being like, I'm not going to tell the father about his kid.
Oh, right.
Is that ethically fine?
I kind of feel like you kind of need to tell.
I feel like she should tell.
Yeah.
Oh,
you have to give him the option.
Oh, I think it's okay for someone to get pregnant and not want to tell the husband. No follow-up. I'm just like, that's how I feel. I do. I'm like, well, I'm like, I wouldn't want to bring Paul Louie into it. It's like, he's working at an all-inclusive resort. He doesn't have time for that. He's a trained dolphin.
Right. Here's the thing, as a sperm donor baby, like, I wish I could call my dad and be like, what's your deal?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I think the implication is that he's going to have Gungle who will act as dad, Elijah.
That's yeah. fine. I still think we should let Paul Louis know.
I feel like we could kind of just be like, hey, like, I'm having this baby. It is yours. Like, I don't expect anything from you. Mm. And like, I just think that you should know. So you have the option to like send me money if you want to visit or not at all. Or you could even be like, hey, the kid's yours, but I don't want you involved. Yeah. I don't know. I feel like you just, I can't imagine like having a kid that was like my DNA out there and like not knowing. That'd me be either. So crazy.
And it's like, it'd be a sick deal because I feel like Hannah would be like, if you want to just send like one puka shell necklace a year, that's enough for me.
Yeah.
And like, that could be
I
cool.
I know, but I don't want there to be any hate because famously hate is energy, but vibes is just feeling.
That's an amazing point. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But the point, I forget who brings it up. Someone was like, you know, the kid's going to get older and be like, who is my dad? And it's like, if they're going to go looking for them, like let's say they're 20 and they're like, I'm going to go find him. And then it's like, then let's say that she finds Paul Louis.
It's Tad's, and it's Tad's almost boyfriend.
Yeah.
Almost,
and yeah. Benny. Yeah.
And then imagine Paul Louis like 20 years later being like, what the fuck? Like,
I mean, we all saw what happened on Gilmore Girls when Luke found out about April.
By the way, that's where my brain went to, and I knew you were going to use that today.
Are you a Gilmore Girl? Fans. And you went to private school in Connecticut?
Yeah, and Chilton was based off of my school.
What the hell, Sally?
I know.
They didn't have cable for that one show.
No.
Well, in season six, the main conflict.
Are you going to explain it all?
No. We can cut it. I talk about Gilmore Girls 7 minutes every episode of our podcast about girls. Yeah, Paul Louis, Marnie is like, you should definitely tell. I personally think it's just like your kid's going to resent you for not telling you.
Well, how hard does she have to try to reach him? Because it's like she did try. It was still like near impossible. He doesn't necessarily have like a landline to call. He kind of just like is at a hotel in a random hotel room. It's like there's no way to actually get in contact
with
him. I think
you could contact him pretty easily.
He doesn't seem like a guy with email/LinkedIn.
I think you could literally call Montauk surf instructors and be like, hey, like I need you to connect me with this guy.
Oh, I never thought about it like that.
Yeah.
But he's in Lances now.
I know, but he'll be back.
Yeah, you can always have. I do like it when people have summer jobs because it's like it's a whole nother existence for you.
Yeah,
I guess. Okay, I'm like, I still don't think she should have to tell him because like at the end of the chase, it is her body, her choice. Like if she's going to have this baby for 9 months, it's like, and also it's like he is like, he's not maybe not even someone she would necessarily want to have in the baby's life because he's also like fairly chaotic himself. Like he doesn't seem like a very like committal guy. He has a whole relationship with himself. He doesn't live in New York, and like she doesn't want to feel the undue pressure of like having him move to New York to take care of the baby because he does feel like a decent guy. Just like in a lot of ways I feel like he'd be lacking as a father.
Yeah, I still think we should run it by him.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, run it by.
But also with Hannah this episode, it's a lot of
she's very mature. Like the way she's able to close relationships in such like a very like defining way, like putting these boundaries up with both Adam and Jessa.
Mm-hmm.
Like we always talk about the marked maturity of Hannah throughout this show, and it's like it is a moment she starts getting pregnant is like the time that she herself is like becoming a mother. Like, and that's also recognized by like Marnie, where Marnie's like, I don't know if you're mature enough. And then you were saying a second ago, like Marnie does come around. It's like, actually, you're going to be an amazing mother. And Elijah like, kind of like witnessing Hannah actually taking this in such a mature way. It's like, I actually think you'll be a good mom, not an amazing mom, but amazing moms raise boring kids.
Mm-hmm.
Like that's all marked by that. And she's really demonstrating that like in this situation where she's like, Jessa, I can't have you in my life anymore. You're only bringing me toxic energy. Like, Adam, I can't be part of this movie project that like is about my life because I just have to be prioritizing this baby.
Mm-hmm.
Did you guys feel the same way?
Yeah, I love the part when Jessa comes in and she's like, you like it happened and like I know you, you can't erase me. And Hannah is literally like, I don't care.
Yeah.
Like because like you did something bad to me and like I don't care. And like that's that.
It was,
and
I literally think it is sad, I rewatched but it's that also scene.
Like I love it. It's like sad and like Jessa's like, okay, but like I know you. Like no other, like there are very few people on this earth that like know you the way I know you, and you can't change that. And she's just like, that's true, but I don't give a I just like don't give a shit.
Because it's interesting.
I love it.
Because it's for six seasons. It's like Jessa's been this like cool girl that like Hannah kind of aspires towards, and like can constantly be getting away with so much and being a bad friend. And mm-hmm. it's like, now Hannah is like, I'm actually over you. Like, yeah, you're not cool to me. And mm-hmm. I don't really care about your whole deal like I used to. And you can't charm your way back into my life. I'm over it.
Yeah. I love it. Because like the whole thing of like Jessa, like she'll escape to another country and then she'll reappear. And it's like, they just like put up with it. And it's like, wait, it's actually kind of what I was saying with Shoshana, where she's like, all of these different paths I could have taken. Mm. Hannah's like, wait, what if I just like decided to not be like have these friends or like have these people? It's like you think right. you like you get in these where it's like, oh, these are the people I'm associated with. Like, I don't know.
It's like fun. Oh, she's my childhood friend. Like, it's always gonna be like this. She's just like,
yeah,
this.
It's like, what if it wasn't though?
Yeah, she's no, like, literally. What if I didn't have to put up with that? Now that you're in a new chapter, you have to like reanalyze your existing relationships. It's like why Elijah had such a negative reaction last episode to being like, no, you're not becoming a mom. I'm not ready for you to be a mom because that's gonna mean our relationship has to change. And then it's really nice to see a gay guy apologize.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's never happened to me.
That episode when Elijah, they're like in their kitchen and he's like, we decided to like live in New York and like be miserable together, basically, is like one of my favorite parts of like the whole series. Cause it's like, no, like we decided this and you're going back on
it. Wait, are you gonna move to New York over to see?
No.
Please.
The way we're like, we're gonna convince you by the end of get over here.
We refuse to have a guest that's only LA based.
Yeah, we'll get you bi-coastal by the end of it.
We'll get you bi-coastal by that.
But yeah, it
is. Can you imagine for the vlog, though, how good it would be to be bi-coastal?
Oh my God, the content.
The content.
You could write off every plane.
Totally.
Literally.
But yeah, Elijah being like, I actually don't think you're going to be a terrible mother. I just don't want you to make me have to change my life.
Yeah.
And I'm like, go off king.
Yeah. I do think it's like when you serve someone big news, and I wonder if you guys experience this as well. It's like, I think you shouldn't, like, people have a very strong initial reaction thing, and then like a few days later when they've actually sat with the news, they're like, oh, I actually have a completely different feeling about this. Mm-hmm. I only had a strong reaction because it was like just like thrown upon me, and like I kind of went to fight or flight, and then I took a few days to chew on this a bit more, and like I'm realizing actually I'm so much more okay with this than I thought. Or do you guys notice that in your own lives as well? It's like when you're first presented with something, your reaction isn't always how you actually feel like a week later once you've processed it a bit more.
Yeah, I'm trying to think of an example in my life, but that sounds right.
Yeah, I think it.
I don't know. I'm really good at having an initial reaction and then gaslighting myself or logistically convincing myself of like a different stance 3 days later. Mm-hmm. I'm so easily moved. Anytime anybody tells me anything with passion, I'm like, okay, I'm on your side. Like, I believe you. Like, I could be so easily swayed mm-hmm. in any direction.
Well, this to me feels like Elijah's really good at journaling.
He's not keeping a journal, bitch.
No, I think he actually did a journal this one time. Like, he wrote down and was like, actually, this is how I'm feeling about Hannah's relationship and why am I feeling about this, because it's so important to ask yourself why questions. And I think he did ask himself why, and that's how he came to the resolution. It's like, it's okay that Hannah's gonna have a baby and she'll like be a good enough mother.
Mm-hmm. I do love that Marnie is able to go through the 7 stages of grief in under 40
she
seconds.
She literally like looks and she's like, I'm into it.
Yeah.
You're like, wait, why are you, how did
that
you decide
that? That made me laugh
out
loud. Yeah. That entire scene, every single line is so good.
Yeah.
Do you know anyone having a baby premature?
Currently?
Yeah.
I mean, like, I know a premature baby.
No,
is that
I think,
okay?
Like, premature.
Whoa. You won't
it's
believe
even it.
That's enough. That's enough.
That's
yeah.
Good. Yeah. Wait, my favorite line, 2 thoughts. My favorite line is in that opening scene where she's like, I literally know 100 pull-out babies. And then Hannah goes, you don't know 100 babies.
Yeah.
So good.
It's like an amazing clapback. You got that.
Oh, too good.
Yeah.
No, wait. So we see the reaction of her, like the news of Hannah, like having this baby, like Marnie's reaction, Elijah's, her dad and Tad, Jessa finding out through Adam. But like, why don't we see Shoshana's reaction? When does that come? I can't even,
I don't
like
think really, because Shoshana actually really separates herself after
yeah,
Hossa's
I guess that's
situation
indicative
from
of
all
like,
the girls.
It's because of what happened with Jamba Jeans.
Yeah,
she's like, I have to get away from these girls.
Yeah, so it's just like she just finds out through the grapevine, and she like at that point doesn't even care about the news. She's like, okay, yeah, I guess she's pregnant.
Well, you bring up a very interesting point, because the season actually starts with a montage of everyone reading Hannah's headline from the like the moth that turned into a modern love piece. Like all the different reactions of her friends and family, and like it is interesting that a lot of this whole show is like people react, a lot of this season specifically is like people reacting in their like their own various ways to like Hannah's decisions and choices and like achievements.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, let's jump into Miss Marnie. I saw the the behind the scenes talkback of this episode, and Jenny Connor and Lena said this is the lowest Marnie's ever been.
Yes, which I thought was so interesting when they said that. I watched that too. Yeah,
I'm like, do us as fans think it's the lowest? I'm like, I could think of a few others.
I don't know. Yeah, when they said that, they were like, it's not like the like Desi being on drugs. It's not like it's this. I was like, is that true?
And like singing with her mother. I guess it is like Marnie's realizing like how fucked up and unhappy she is with her life, and she's really good at denying that. So I feel like she's really faced with like, I'm gonna end up like my mother, and I like need to figure out how to have a different type of relationship with men. I also think it's like Ray breaking up with her like has set her a little bit like into like,
yeah,
am I the problem?
Right. I'm trying to think, because if I were to pick her lowest moment, I think it would be like Ray dumping her, but her reaction in this episode, I'm trying to think.
Wait, this is a fun segment. What is Marnie's lowest point?
No, literally, I think like her and like Ray turning her down.
Yeah.
She's literally like, wait, I was only dating you because like you were meant to give me attention. Literally. Like that, like who are you to dump me?
To be dumped by Ray.
Wait, isn't it where she's like eating the pizza and she's like, I literally don't give a shit about you. That's why I'm eating pizza in front of you.
Yeah, that was seasons ago, right?
Oh, that was. I'm trying to think. Because I guess he's kind of ended it with her.
Well, the breakup is like Hermie dies, the guy who runs Ray's.
Right. And he like realizes like things are more important.
Well, Marnie is like, I have to get to Pilates. Right. And Ray's like, why don't you go to Pilates and never come back?
Right.
We need a breakup. And Marnie's like, are you kidding? What the hell?
She's so many low moments. I will give her that.
I don't feel like she processes that as a low moment, but that's what I would pick, is like Ray dumping her.
Right. Well, I think when she sings Stronger, of course, might be her lowest moment. Or when her music video that everyone hates is, and she's kind of working.
Philosophy is pretty low.
Yeah, but that's really low.
Yeah, what does Hannah say in this episode? Can you, Marnie's like, can you believe Ray dumped me? And she's like, yeah, you've been nothing but an evil cunt to him.
Yeah.
Well, I think she also becomes a godmother this episode. That's kind of huge.
I really feel like Hannah becoming a mother and kind of having her shit together. It's like Marnie has spent their entire friendship being like, I'm the organized one, I'm the girl boss one. And for Hannah to be like, I'm doing this and I'm actually pretty fucking responsible, and Marnie recognizing that, she like finally has to be like, maybe I'm the messy one. Mm-hmm. And it's like, what do you do with that?
Yeah.
I don't know.
But... yeah, Marnie in New Jersey. How do you feel about that girl?
At the love you?
Yeah, I love you.
I love you. Yeah, not good. Wait, actually, my second favorite line beyond the 100 pull-out babies line is when her mom is like, by now, Marnie, you should recognize a high person. Because it's like two separate times. Like, she literally can't
figure out.
Like,
she is so bad at knowing when a guy is high.
Yeah, which is also so fucking me. Like, really? I literally can never tell. Yeah, have I dated a man that I didn't know was like on drugs? 100%.
Okay, oh, Marnie Moon going stronger than
Marnie
ever.
Moon. I'm a Marnie Moon. So I love that line because I'm like, that's so me. Like, she literally, her mom is like, he's on drugs. Like, what do you not see? And she's like, oh my God. I cannot believe.
Do not go to sleep last night. It's like, he's falling.
Yeah.
That was so me in high school, though. And I was hanging out with friends who would suddenly laugh at me a lot more than usual. And then I found out they were high on weed. And I was like, what the hell?
Yeah.
How did you do that?
I think it's hard to know what a high person looks like when you're like never high yourself.
Mm-hmm.
She's like, she doesn't realize what an altered state of being kind of looks like or feels like. So she can never like internalize it in others. Also, she is so, again, self-obsessed. It's like she wouldn't even take time.
I think that's what it is. Like, she's so focused on how people are perceiving her that she, like, literally isn't, like, observing, like, how other people are acting. Yeah.
Her yelling at her mom being like, I'm like this because of you. It's like, uh-oh. It's very season six.
Hurt people, literally.
Rita being, like, with her vape, like, girl, what you talking about? It's so chill. I'm going to go kiss the venue owner.
No, I think New Jersey culture, a lot of it is about, like, women making men happy.
I wouldn't know anything about that.
Have you been to New Jersey?
I think I've driven through it.
You're so good at doing that.
Really good at doing that. Yeah, that I've definitely, like, stopped at a gas station there or something.
Okay, but you get the whole vibe.
Yeah, that's how I know that I've been there.
You're in New Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it is a very, like, this is the first episode where we really get, like, a big indication of, like, a culture outside of New York, which is so, like our New Jersey culture in general. Like, it is so funny. Lena Dunham does such a great job of, like, capturing, like, the stylized, like, how all these people are in, like, mob wife attire before it was, like, even popularized or, like, satirized. Like, they are doing it so earnestly, which is so fun. Mm-hmm. Everyone has, like, fringe on their jackets and studs on their coats.
I also think it's foreshadowing like Hannah's exodus from New York City and basically the idea of like this show about navigating your 20s in New York. It's like a common thing that happens is people spend their 20s in New York and then they leave.
Yeah,
New
you
York.
Have to leave at some point.
Wait, I don't want to.
You don't have to.
I don't have to.
I mean, it's just like for some people, like it's going to happen at some point. Like that's me with LA. It's like it's going to happen at some point.
Do you think
you're
going to leave at some point?
I don't feel like I'm going to live there forever.
I'm like, I think I'll live there when I'm old. You ever see an old lady in LA and you're like, I could be her?
I mean, like maybe, but like I don't think I'm going to be her.
Whoa.
So like at some point you have to leave.
Can we talk a little bit about Adam's movie?
Mm-hmm.
So for 6 seasons, I've always wanted to know how the hell did Hannah and Adam meet?
Yeah, that is my, oh God, I'm literally saying everything is my favorite part, but I love that reveal.
It's okay, you love all the parts.
Yeah, and I feel like there are some people that when they watched that episode, they might have like clicked off, like thinking the episode was over,
right,
and they didn't see how they met.
Oh my God, it's so powerful. Him writing on her, that was hot.
Yeah, and then the inside the episode thing, they said, she said that, Lena said that she wrote it in like in a season 2 like flashback, but he was like shirtless in it or something, and then they cut it. I'm like, what if that had been in it?
What if that had been in season 2? Our lives would be different.
Completely different.
Okay, they've never done a flashback before, so it'd be crazy to add one then.
Yeah, well, true.
But I was so curious for so long, how the hell did those two meet?
I know.
I just assumed it was like at a bar. I don't know what I thought, actually.
I was like,
we knew he was a stranger. Like, we knew there wasn't any, like, friends of friends.
I was like, it's Grindr.
Fake Hannah is so cool to me. I want to know everything about her.
She's better than any of these characters by far. She's an amazing character actress.
I
want to
follow
her.
That character on Instagram now.
There should be a spinoff.
Yeah.
You should get her on the pod.
I'm like, yeah, we'll do a Queen Charlotte of her.
It is kind of Mean Girls musical vibes.
I love Mean Girls the musical, the movie, and no one can tell me otherwise. Did you see it?
Yeah, I did.
It's good, right?
I thought it was fun, like a little bit of nostalgia, but also like not like my favorite.
Yeah, of course.
No,
I mean, what
was.
If it was better?
That'd be great.
But no worries.
No worries. I'm good.
If anything, when like a brunette woman in her 50s like uses her existing IP to do more with it, make more money, I'm like, go off, girl boss.
Yes,
please. Everyone should make a dollar.
But do you think Full Disclosure is an amazing film that will win Cannes? How do you say that festival? Was that a joke?
I said
Isn't it
in
just
front of
Cannes?
Cannes.
And she says Cannes.
Actually, I was playing categories with my mom the other day, and I was telling her that like we were talking about Cannes. It's and I said can, and she goes, she started laughing at me in her deepest, darkest laugh, and she goes, it's con, not can.
Okay, because Hannah said it, and I'm like, I can tell that this is a joke because Hannah is saying it wrong, but I don't know the right way.
Yeah, I just know it doesn't have an S.
Yeah, okay. I don't think it would win at the festivals, but it is cool
it
to
is
see.
Brilliant. No. Also, in this kind of world, things that we care about, it's like any TV show, anytime you think they're making good media inside of it, or like even bad media, it's like that stuff is kind of the best perceived art form to ever be created. It's like Marvelous Mrs. Maisel, it's like she's one of the most talented stand-ups of all time, but she's telling like hack jokes that don't even make sense. But like, that's how TV works. You can still be the worst and still be the best.
I just can't believe Adam and Jessa can figure out how to fund, shoot, and edit a film in the course of 2 episodes.
No clue.
But okay, you know the closing scene when they're showing Hannah's face?
Mm-hmm.
What does it mean?
I don't, okay. Well, in the inside of the episode, they were kind of like, oh, it's like her realizing like maybe there's unfinished business with him or something. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, I don't know. I feel like she knows. I don't know. I don't feel like they can go back to any. I don't know. Well, there is that episode later that like they kind of have like
good
a moment together.
Right.
But I don't. Yeah, good soup. I don't know what it means. I think she is just maybe like sad or something. Because what does he say? Like bed's getting cold. And I bet she's just maybe like, oh my God. Yeah. Like one time I was in his bed.
My
just sadness.
Yeah.
I don't think she's like, oh, unfinished business.
Huh.
Even though they do kind of have that in a later episode, like kind of an afternoon into night together. But
literally,
I don't feel like that was exploring unfinished business. I think that was just them like playing house and like reminiscing. But
yeah.
I think they both know it's done.
Well, my thought was that Adam and Hannah, like their interaction at the beginning episode where like Adam's like, I need you to watch this because I don't know if it's actually real or not. Like, mm-hmm. was our experience real? And she's watching it and she's kind of realizing like that's actually, she's now in a more mature place, like time has passed since her and Adam, and she's, like it's also so real to her, like she's watching this and she's having a realization of like what the relationship actually meant to her, like how she's such a different person from then, and like it is reading as real to her.
Yeah.
I guess it's like she spent so long being mad and hurt about like the dissolution of the relationship that she forgot
the
how
good parts.
Yeah, and like how real it was and how connected they really were. And so she's almost probably convinced herself to try and like heal from the relationship like it was never anything. So to see him make art about how what they had was real,
yeah,
probably feels really cool.
Yeah.
And or weird.
Maybe it's also too like she's pregnant with a guy that she like barely knows and she's like, oh, I could have just as easily been pregnant with a guy that I do know yeah. so intimately that she's probably like that probably feels yeah. so crazy to be like, oh, like a scene of them having sex and like she just had sex. I don't know, maybe
it
it's
is
that
no way funny sequence.
That makes me scared to be a mom, like you become a mom and then you just I'm like, what if I was a mom with a different guy,
right?
But
it's just so funny for her to like walk into the apartment, talk to Elijah for 10 seconds and he's only talking about himself. She runs into a room because she just like literally can't handle that the second. And then Elijah's like, it's veggie burger night. We made a commitment. She doesn't leave the door. She then calls Atlantis all you can eat resort. No one picks up there. Then she watches a movie and it's like, it's a porno. Great. And then she falls in love with whatever's happening on screen or like mm-hmm. has this like real moment that we were talking about.
Yeah. Well, it's also like Adam says something like you need to like, don't you think watching it would like heal whatever, like he's kind of like, oh, it would be good for you to watch it. So yeah. like maybe she decides to watch it because she's like, oh, maybe he's right, like maybe I do need to watch it to close yeah. this chapter. I don't know,
it's definitely interesting. I love a show within a show.
I yeah. love a show within inside a show, except it's sometimes so hard to watch someone watching a TV screen.
It is like we get to see so many shots of Hannah on her laptop in her bedroom.
Yeah,
but I'm like, that's
how do they
cool.
never have smudges on the screen.
That's
I'm like, it's
point.
So clear.
She would have so many.
She would have so many smudges.
Yeah. HBO wouldn't allow it, though.
HBO wouldn't allow it, but, like, Hannah, the character, would.
I am just, like, a huge part of being in your 20s is being alone in your room on your laptop.
Yeah, I'm happy they included it.
Yeah, because a lot of TV shows fail to do that.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, the interesting...
Gilmore Girls is never on her laptop.
Well, they don't have...
Yeah. Well,
they actually,
because
they're on computer.
Hardly ever, though.
When they're making reservations.
Did we already talk about Jessa?
Yeah, we touched
kind
it.
Of, yeah.
Okay. Just and Elijah's acting career, we're wishing him the best.
Elijah has
yeah.
been the best moments in history where it's you're so good at reading a script even though it's not really meant for you. And everyone's like, you are amazing at that. Let me cast you right now.
Right.
I've always wanted to like be a janitor at like a casting agency and I just walk in a room but I'm doing my thing so well. They're like, we have to book you.
When he's like doing those lines, like he is low-key being so annoying though, because it's like, have you ever like read lines with a friend who's like trying to like memorize and like, it's like, wait, hold on. Like you don't need to be doing all that. Like it's not, and
it's
he's
not
just like
your...
trying so hard. And it's like, relax.
She was being way too sweet about it. She was like, you're a god.
Yeah, like
if
no,
I was her, I'd be like, can you,
I'd be like, relax. Like
I love his directing note as well, where it's like, act up here, not here. Yeah. And he and she's like, what the hell are you talking about?
I love it. Okay, well, let's get into it.
Yeah.
Girl, get your Glock. It's rapid fire time. We're gonna ask you series of rapid fire questions. Please answer them as quickly as you can.
Okay.
Are you school girl or are you getting schooled girl?
I'm a schoolgirl.
What's your favorite utensil?
Spoon.
Are you the voice of your generation or a voice of a generation?
Voice of my generation.
Who are you a horrible cunt to?
Oh my god. Like myself.
Do you know 100 babies?
Not currently.
Very gay son or beautiful daughter?
Very gay son.
Which, by the way, Hannah Horvath's the first person to say gay son thought daughter.
Oh, yeah, she kind of is.
She did like 8 years before the rest
she
of
did.
Society.
Yeah, very gay son.
What is the right kind of slutty?
The right kind of slutty. I guess like kind of like freak in the sheets, but like lady in the streets kind of.
That's a really good answer.
Yeah.
What or is this a dream come true or a bad dream come true?
Dream come true, being in Brooklyn doing
yes.
it.
Yes.
Can you love your parents so much that you can't get an erection?
Love your parents so much.
Who did that
no.
happen to?
Steven.
Steve.
Yeah, no, I think you could, if you try hard enough, you can get an erection no matter what.
Are we preventing you from being the godmother you are meant to be?
No, you guys would never.
Are you in the wrong side of your 20s?
Yeah.
Yes. And she said that and I was like, I'm on the wrong side of my 20s.
No, when she said that, I was like, oh shit, I never thought about it that way. But yeah, I am.
To be 26 is like the worst thing that can happen.
Oh my God. I literally have a whole YouTube video where I realized I was 26 and I was rewatching Girls. Like literally, that is like a whole video on my YouTube channel because I was like, I'm 26 and they're 26 and this is the wrong side of my 20s. Like it all aligned.
It comes really quick. Like you think you're 23 forever and then you wake up and you're 26.
Yeah. And you start, you have to start rounding up.
Next week.
I actually think that 26 is the better side of 20s.
26 is fine, but like once you get to like 27, 28, like it really starts getting scary.
Oh, because Saturn return.
What? Has your Saturn returned?
No, I have no clue if my Saturn has returned. How would I know?
It happens when you're 27.
Oh shit, I'm 27.
And everything changes.
Oh my
God. Are you
God.
Feeling a reckoning?
You know, like I literally feel, I'm feeling so many changes coming.
Oh my gosh.
I'm moving to Brooklyn, y'all.
Oh my God, we did it. We did it.
Let's
we have
do
one
our
more
last segment.
That outfit in Brooklyn.
That's when you pair Brooklyn then versus Brooklyn now.
You've now been in Brooklyn for almost 2 hours, so mm-hmm. I feel like you're an expert.
Basically, yeah.
Was there anything that stood out into this episode that felt very of the time?
To me, something really interesting was vape culture. That first off, it was the New Jersey moms who are really indulging in it. Like
now, it's Gen Z TikTokers. Before it was Rita Wilson and her crew.
Literally, except the mom had a Juul, and in 2016, Juuls were huge.
Really? When did vaping come into your lives?
2015.
I remember seeing my first Juul in college. I forget what year in college, but like, yeah,
it's
people just
your
charging
year.
Them.
People were
charging them.
Tulane was like the mecca for Juul culture. There's an Instagram account, a meme called Juul Lane.
Oh, wow.
There's just so many
no Juuls. Clue.
Yeah, there's so many Juuls that we had to make a meme account about it.
Wow.
I just remember having to watch in like my senior year of high school a video of what the inside of a Juul pod looks like. And it's like
and
cotton
it's
and
oh,
battery acid.
I need to watch that.
And they're like, you're inhaling like fucked up shit. Well. And it's so cheaply made. And I'm like, well, that's the point, no?
That's why we're doing
that's
it.
Why we're doing it. Hello.
Well, the other mom comes out with the most like serious vape of all time that kind of looks like a Wii remote and she's sucking on it.
I feel like Hannah wouldn't have the kid today. Is that crazy to say?
Where did that come from?
I just feel like 2024 Hannah would be like, I'm not bringing a baby into the earth. I can't afford it.
Literally.
Yeah, but probably. I mean, I think it's crazy that she's having, like, do you think it makes sense that she's having the baby, like, in this?
No,
and
it's my main gripe with the end of Girls.
I just don't feel like she would have it. I mean, I feel like she would move out of New York City. I feel like that's a good ending, perhaps, like, taking a job. But, like, I just don't believe that she would have the baby.
I just think it's, like, of course, I had to wrap up the show, but I'm also, like, the craziest person you know actually does crazy things, too.
I guess, yeah.
A big part of being a crazy person is you have to do crazy things.
I guess, but the thing that's so crazy is that this show was so about this generation of millennial woman, like, doing career Barbie. So for her to then immediately in the 6 years be like, no, it's time to be mom Barbie. It seems like, I don't know, as somebody watching it now, as somebody who like grew up thinking like you're not really becoming a mom, like girls now have jobs instead. It seems like a disservice for it to be like it has to end with her being a mom.
Yeah, because like how old is she by the time the series ends? Is she like 27? Yeah, like that would be like me having a baby and
imagine
moving. Like,
I don't want
to do
that.
It's just like not happening.
It's like you have your YouTube channel to focus on.
Yeah, I can't have a
baby.
That's crazy.
I have to vlog.
Literally.
Wait, they did discontinue Pregnant Barbie too.
Pregnant Barbie. And it's also just like New York moms are New York moms when they're 34.
Yeah.
Like, why are you doing it 8 years early? Like, I could get Hannah becoming a mother in New York in 8 more years. Why does it have to be now?
I like her being crazy. I really do.
Also,
like,
like
it's fun
there's
to have a
so much in the show about, like, them, like, being broke. And, like, it's, like, literally, how are you going to afford that? Like, I know she moves out and she, like, gets, like, whatever. But, like,
she's making $23,000 a year.
Oh my God, when did they reveal that?
In the last episode, she made a Word doc of reasons she shouldn't be a mom.
Oh, I do remember that. I do remember that. Yeah. Like, literally, that is like, how.
I'm like, girl.
Yeah.
You're on food stamps.
Yeah. That is a big gripe with the show.
But.
Oh,
well. Whatever.
No one actually likes how it ends. Very few.
Yeah. Well, the second to last episode, I love. Last episode.
No, exactly.
Like, literally not needed.
We're not going to cover that one.
That one. I remember watching the second to last episode being like, oh my God, the series is over. And then there was like another one. And I was like, wait, what? Which I feel like is everyone's reaction.
Yeah.
It's hell.
Any other things? Oh, Andrew Rannells reading for a straight role. I think gay guys are finally getting their chance to play straight. And he was kind of doing ahead of the curve.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty timeless.
Well, actually, it isn't. I think gay guys were forced to be gay guys for so long.
Jess's dress was wicked.
I don't even.
It was like t-shirt. It was, there was something very H&M going on, and to see Jessa in that look, it was just like, remember when American Eagle was like that, and it's like cool girls were wearing that, but now it's like normal girls wear that.
Mm-hmm.
2016 was a year that I guess Jennifer Lawrence had acting chops. They referred
did
to
they
Marnie.
Reference it?
Yeah. Why did I think they said Jennifer Lopez? Did they say Jennifer Lawrence? Lopez.
Oh, did I say Jennifer Lawrence?
Yeah.
I meant Jennifer Lopez. They said, Marnie, you're just like Jennifer Lawrence without the acting chops. She's like, it's great to know that people think of me like Jennifer Lopez.
Yeah, she's like, that's exactly how I want to be described. Yeah. I'm trying to think of something that was very of the time in that episode.
Marnie's crimped hair wasn't even of that time.
No. No.
I feel like...
Sure. I actually think that...
Now more than ever movies.
Were kind of bigger. Yeah. Oh, now more than ever, yeah. I think like because of TikTok, we forgot about short films for a little bit. But I think in that time, they were becoming more popular.
Are we in a short film bubble where everybody we know is making a short film, but really it's the money's in vertical? Well, you're trying to get away from vertical.
Yeah.
No, people,
would you
I
do
think
short
going back
film
to shorts.
Or not really?
I don't know. I feel like my film bro days are behind me.
Yeah,
like I loved going to the movies and stuff. I don't think I would ever like make a short film.
Are you
film
a Letterboxd
or...
girl?
Yeah.
Thank God.
Absolutely. Yeah.
God.
Huge Letterboxd girl.
Okay, are there any other culture? I kind of, no, I think there's, this episode's actually not about culture. It's about people that aren't affected by culture.
Totally. Right. Quote that.
And also leather gloves. It's like, who is buying leather gloves anymore?
Yeah.
Leather gloves has been out,
I
think.
Know. This episode was really fully disclosing where we're headed and where we came from. It was so, who were you? Who are you?
Literally.
And who are you about to be? So
beautiful. I think it was a perfect episode. Thank you so much for
I
coming
know.
On.
Oh my God. It literally like the honor of a lifetime.
It was so fun.
This yeah. is,
where
I
can
mean,
people find you?
Yeah. Okay. I am at Sally Darr Griffin on where am I? TikTok? Instagram. Goodreads. If you're into Goodreads.
Oh my God.
This is like the plug that I do at the end of all my videos. I'm just like repeating it. At Sally Darr on Letterboxd.
Gorge.
On
oh, I'm following
else?
That.
Snapchat.
SDG. It's so
like Snap?
SJP.
Yeah. Snapchat is like where the money is right now.
Yeah.
Not that I'm monetized, that. But like that's the tea.
That's what we hear.
Snapchat. Whenever you see like Instagram people being like, follow me on Snapchat.
They're millionaires.
There's a reason. There's
yeah.
a reason. But yeah, at Sally Darr, at Sally Darr Griffin, like everywhere.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
And Sally Darr Griffin's about to be everywhere because she's about to be bi-coastal. We can feel it.
Yeah.
We can feel
totally.
It. check out all her new vlogs. We're really excited about them. They're going to change hearts
literally.
And minds.
You can see me like making my way to Brooklyn in this
oh my God.
Today's vlog. Yeah, my New York City vlog.
Oh my God, I can't wait to link
oh
it.
Oh my God, gorge.
We'll be back next week with episode 7. Till then, see you.
Yeah.